Alright folks, this video is all about mixing, or really I should say cutting what are known as breaks. Now, for a lot of people out there, you know what breaks are. Quite a few, you don't. Well, breaks is not dissimilar, let's say, to the likes of hip-hop or drum and bass. Hip-hop, very slow BPM. Drum and bass is almost the equivalent of double-time hip-hop. Breaks, somewhere in between, really. What we're dealing with here is not necessarily loads of vocals, loads of melody, but we're dealing with a lot of drumming. Now, if you imagine, let's say we have the godfather of soul, James Brown, and he had the funky drummer play that fantastic beat. If you can imagine a modern day version of the funky drummer beat, but done with a drum machine, and then adding loads more influences, loads more electronic effects, then you have got near enough what is known as breaks, or what is, well, hopefully what you understand where I'm coming from. Right, the two tracks I'm going to be using, well, there's three actually, I'll probably mix one in at the end, is from this LP here. It's a triple 12 inch, it's Y4K Next Level Breaks. Two tracks on this side is Hybrid, a track entitled Burning, and this guy here is Elektrotek Superfly. Now, first of all, I'm going to play you a little bit of the Hybrid track. Let's have a listen. This one is entitled Burning. Now, to the discerning ear, you're probably thinking, how do you count bars? Where is the timing? Where's the 1, 2, 3, 4? Well, it's there. It's there. All the time, for anyone out there who, you know how to count bars, you can hear it. For the people out there who can't count bars, you'll get it eventually. Don't panic. Let's put the track on a little bit. Right, mainly this particular tutorial is about something called chopping. Now, what we've got here, we've got two sliders, I've got them both up. Two turntables, a Technics SL1200, and the mixer SL1200 Mark II. The mixer in the middle is the Pioneer DJM 600. Two faders all the way up to the top. What I'm going to be doing is using the crossfade, going from one side to the other. Now, where's my piece of paper? I've got the crossfader curve set to that. There's a good reason. I want to be able to go from that track, and as soon as I move the crossfade over, a tiny amount, I want this track, bang, to come in straight away. I don't want a slow transition from one track to the other. I want in, out, shake it all about. You do the okie cokie and you turn around. Never mind. Right, all right, so what I'm going to do now, play this, and I'm going to scat. What is scatting? Have a listen. Now, normally when people cut, they get in a rut. That rhymes. Because what they tend to do is they count 1, 2, 3, 4, and they'll do this. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Like so. All right, you can do that. But with breaks, like I said, if we go back to the funky drummer, there's a lot more into it. House beat, you've just got boom, 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 boom. With breaks, there's more going on. You've got loads of hi-hat, loads of bass drums. It's a whole mishmash of music, mainly a mishmash of the beats. So what you can do, you don't just have to do one, start again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. You can do 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, like so. You're almost getting to the stage whereby you're being a bit of a turntablist, but only on the crossfade, and you're going from one to the other. Now, of course, you've got to get them in time. The tracks have got to sound relatively well together. When I say in time, counts of beat, bars, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So what I'll do now, I'll play a little bit of this, and we'll have a listen to this, listen to that. There's no mixing involved here. It's what's known as chopping from one side to the other. Also, sometimes it's known as cutting. So we'll listen to this guy now, which is Elektrotek, a track entitled Superfly. Here we go. Right, what I'm going to do is get this one ready at a beat where I know it's suitable to bring it in. That is the count of one. Let's have a listen.
1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Okay, we'll go back over to this guy here. And I'll start it just after this small break here. Here we go. Here we go. I'm going to start this one here. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, let's put it to the test.
You know, life is all about expression. You only live once and you're not coming back, so express yourself here.
Wide angle back on. Now, there's one way how we can actually mix a track whilst we cut or chop. What I want you to imagine is, let's say for example, this one's playing, we're bringing this one in. Well, when you're cutting, you could make sure you've got this one playing most of the time and slowly start to cut this one in a little bit. Imagine a scale from 1 to 10. Well, all of a sudden we're starting at number 1 and we're bringing this one in. 1, 1, 1. Eventually, we're going to start to bring this at 2, or we're going to start to bring this one in more. But this one will be slightly less. And then we're going to start to bring this one in even more, which means this one will be slightly less. And then in the middle, we're half and half. So we're actually going from this one to this one just the same amount. And then what we do, we start to bring this one in more and we use this one less. We start to bring this one even more and we use this one less. And then eventually, at the last part of the mix stroke cut, whatever you want to call it, we're only bringing this one in a tiny amount. So in other words, we are using the crossfade, we are chopping, we are cutting, but we're actually doing a chop, cut, mix. Now there's the difference. So you don't have to just go from here slowly over to that side. Right, what we'll do, we'll bung this one. No, actually, I won't play the third one. So I hope that's been a general sort of idea for you. And don't forget, if you've got any videos exactly like this, tutorials, stick them underneath. Practice and enjoy. Thank you very much.